today. From Nissan Stadium in Nashville, Tennessee. This is the National Football League. We'll see Ryan Tannehill and the Tennessee Titans taking on Trevor Lawrence and the Jacksonville Jaguars.
Being located in the Music City, this building has hosted a lot of great music acts since its inception, but this is what she was made for, NFL football, and that's what we have today in Nashville at Nissan Stadium. This crowd here fired up for football as a moment ago their Titans were introduced. This should be a good one as the Titans get set to match up with the Jacksonville Jaguars. Has us all set, and we are underway from Nashville, Tennessee. And the opening kickoff will not be returned, as that will be a touchback. The Jacksonville offense getting ready to begin this first drive, and at the helm, the number one overall pick back in April, Trevor Lawrence, the rookie out of Clemson.
And for many people, there's a lot of pressure that comes with being the presumptive number one overall pick for two, if not 3 years now. But Trevor Lawrence has handled it well. The Jacksonville Jaguars excited to have him in town, to say the least, because they've started guys like Gardner Minshew, Jake Luton, Mike Glennon just in the last season. But let's face it, they now have their franchise quarterback.
Now Lawrence on first down. That's out wide here for Robinson. And he's upended at the 33 following a good pickup of 8.
I like it. I like it. I like it. Get everyone involved in the passing game, and you know you can create those great mismatches throwing it to your guys out of the backfield.
And on the first drive, that can also help establish some rhythm, right?
I think so, and gets everyone involved. They feel like they're part of it and really gets them amped up as they go forward.
Here's a second and 2 now from the 33. And they'll run it. This is James Robinson. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
Every time I see James Robinson make a run, as we just saw there, one word comes to mind for me, and that's determined. Undrafted, out of Illinois State, always doubted, and all he did, finished 6th in the NFL in rushing. What a find he was in 2020, and he expects that to continue in 2021.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Here's Lawrence to throw. He's going to float this one deep right side. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Janoris Jenkins. And the Titans are going to get the football here as they force the INT on the game's opening drive. Now come the Titans for their first possession, led by Ryan Tannehill in his 10th NFL season and 3rd with Tennessee.
And the former Miami Dolphin had a career renaissance in 2019 with Tennessee and carried it over into 2020. A career-high 32 touchdowns, just 7 interceptions, and those were the fewest he'd thrown in a full season. And speaking of full seasons, he played all 16 games for the first time since 2015. He's got to be excited about 2021.
Tannehill and the Titans come up now 1st and 10 at the 34. Escaping the pressure right. And Tannehill's got the first as he slides to a halt.
Partner, he was was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
Tannehill on first down. He's got his tight end, Anthony Firkser. And he's taken down inside the 30. Really been an ideal start for them. They get the turnover on the opening possession. Now here they are moving the ball straight down the field on their first drive.
And that feels good, but you know on their side of the field, all they're thinking is finish this drive off because they took it away, right? So now you've got them back on their heels a little bit. Now go down, put a touchdown on them. Look out. You've won the mental battle early in the game, and that may carry over for you.
And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. That opening drive rhythm continues right into play number three.
Whatever they decided that they wanted to run before the game, it's working pretty well for them right now. Moving the ball downfield at a nice rate. And guess what? I think the chain crew might have to get a little oxygen over there. They have to keep moving downfield with first downs on each play.
Now a first and 10 at the 11. Now Tannehill. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And down inside the 10 here before he's out of bounds right around the 7.
It certainly feels like there are more stars at the tight end position than there were even 10 years ago. And I think it's become more of a glamour position because of the ways it can hurt a defense, and guys want to be involved. They can be in line, close to the line of scrimmage. They can split out like receivers. But hands, route running, speed, and some toughness to go across the middle, you put it all together, you got a heck of a tight end candidate.
It's been a good opening drive offensively thus far, but you know they don't want to waste it and settle for a field goal attempt after that incompletion. So this is a big play coming up here on third down.
They head to the line facing a 3rd and 7 following the incompletion on second down. Out of the gun, Tannehill. And a quick throw here, that's complete. 2 yards is all they'll get on the completion. It's fourth down.
Well, the coverage was tight that time. They allowed the pass underneath to him, but they rallied to him pretty fast, too. Converged on him and got him down. That'll bring up fourth down.
Here's Bullock now for the Titan field goal. From the right hash here, should be an easy one. Bullock's kick is good. Titans hit the scoreboard first. It's 3-0. Well, after marching down the field, only getting 3 there, kind of feels like a win for the defense.
And it does. They'll go to the sideline feeling a lot better that they didn't give up a touchdown after the march against them. But if I were the offense, I wouldn't hang my head over that one. That's a good drive, and 3 points were put on the board.
After the field goal now, it's Bullock to kick it away. Jamal Agnew now to return it. And out a little across the 25 to the 27. Trevor Lawrence and the Jacksonville offense ready to go back to work. He'll look to shake off the interception on the opening drive. He should at least be comforted that it resulted in 3, not 6.
And if I were him, I would be the guy all the way out on the field greeting my defense down, saying, thanks a lot. You held them to a field goal after I turned it over. That's a big defensive stand for them. He needs to go out now and make up for what he did on the first drive.
First carry for Carlos Hyde. Able to shake free for about 7 up to the 35. You often say that sort of opens the playbook now, 2nd and short. What do you think, early shot here?
I like where you're going. Obviously, we've been together for a while because you know me. I want to take that shot early and loosen things up.
On second down, it's Robinson. And he'll get this only up to about the 35. Give him a yard on the run there, and that's going to set up a third down and two.
Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
On third down, it's Robinson. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means fourth down.
Fourth and short, partner. I mean, this would be a really risky call. Here we are in the first quarter.
On your own side of the field.
But, boy, what a tone setter that would be to go for it and get it, wouldn't it?
You're gritty today. I like it.
I'm feeling it.
On fourth down, on is Logan Cook to punt. Back deep, Chester Rogers. So possession goes over here on the punt, and it'll be Titan football. The Titans coming back onto the field for their second drive. They've got a 3-0 lead and the football as they start first and 10. They start the drive with Peterson. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this across the 25-yard line. They had three tight ends in on that set, and they were really good at blocking for their running back.
And give them a lot of credit, because in football nowadays, tight ends coming out of college often don't block very often. These guys have really developed into superior blockers, and that's why they use them in this formation so often.
AP, Adrian Peterson. Peterson a first down and more as they finally wrangle him in at the 48. 51 yards rushing for him as he's got the afternoon off to a great start. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Now a play fake, and it's Tannehill. He'll get this one complete. That's A.J. Brown. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35.
Well, it certainly doesn't matter if it's been through the air like on this play or on the ground. I don't know what's going on with this defense. In a sense, they've been AWOL on this drive so far. Three plays, three first downs given up. They've got to find the answers, and they've got to find them quick.
So in Jacksonville territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 36. They give it to Peterson. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5.
Brandon, 5 yards on that run. Let's get back to the huddle and make sure if you're back, You spend time with your offensive line and give them credit. Hard to move those 300-plus pounders at the line of scrimmage, and they did for a significant chunk of yardage.
From the 31, Tannehill. That's complete to his tight end, Firkser. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10.
That was good protection there. No, that was great protection there because it allowed him to lock in on his receiver. Although I think he was looking for his tight end on the corner route all the way. Nice connection there for a really nice gain.
They had to settle for three last drive, hoping the second go around ends in six. In good position, first and 10. Handoff comes to Peterson, and he'll take this one inside the 10, down to the 8. A gain of 3, second down.
He's had success on this drive, but not on this play.
Finally, they bowed up defensively. I think they were determined not to let him take it pretty much all the way down the field.
Yeah, it looks like they handled their run responsibilities correctly this time. When we call them run fits, everyone was in the right place.
Second down, Peterson again. And into the end zone for a Tennessee touchdown. Adrian Peterson, an 8-yard touchdown run. And the Titans are able to extend their lead. That almost looked too easy, and I think thanks goes to the offensive line for making it look easy.
Yeah, I agree with you totally on that one. I'm not sure how much everyone understands the preparations that go into a game for an offensive line. Because there's a reason that running backs and quarterbacks give them big gifts at the end of a season after a big year. The consistency and the continuity it takes to know each other and execute their blocks is pretty impressive.
Bullock good on the extra point. So that drives 7 plays in length. And it's capped off by a touchdown run by Adrian Peterson. Send this one away after the touchdown. To return, here's Agnew. And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27. Rookie Trevor Lawrence of the Jaguar offense ready to take over. Start on the ground with Robinson here. And not a whole lot doing there as he'll get it up to about the 28-yard line. The tackle was by the Boston College product, Harold Landry.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. And what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least 2 first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
On 2nd and 9, Lawrence. Dancing to his left, and he slides and covers up at the end as he's going to be able to pick up decent yardage. The heavy set out there. 3 tight ends in the formation for 3rd and 3. Lawrence with the handoff to Robinson. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down.
Let's go.
I think I saw a lot of shoulders just drop there. And what I mean by that is they finally were able to relax a little bit because that was an important play call. They needed to pick up that first down at this stage of the game.
Yeah, couldn't afford another quick drive and out. Throw it with Lawrence.
Rush coming, and he's taken down.
Credit the sack there to Harold Landry. Two-minute mark of the first half, 10-0, our score. A reminder, coming up at halftime, Jonathan Coachman will join us from Orlando with our halftime report, but business to take care of before we get there.
A two-minute drill before the coach's two-minute drill.
Throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down.
Well, that was an okay hook up there with his tight end, but unfortunately, they didn't get the kind of yards they had hoped for. That's going to bring up third down.
On third down, Robinson. The Titans going to use the first of their timeouts, as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Here's Logan Cook now, as he's on to punt for Jacksonville. First kick, 47. This one looks good as well. That'll be a 43-yard punt, but a net of just 33 following a 10-yard return. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And still plenty of time remaining here in the half, more than a minute. And we'll see if they just want to protect that lead or try to add on to it.
Well, with as much time as is left on the clock, I would imagine it would be the latter. I think they're going to try and add on to it. So what they're going to tell the team is very simply, if you can get out of bounds after making a play downfield, terrific. If you can't, everyone hustle to the line of scrimmage, either run another play or clock it and start over again.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. From the gun, here's Tannehill. Quick slant to Brown. And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield. Now Tennessee going to use the second of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. To throw is Tannehill. He'll drop this down to Peterson. They'll contain him to just four. Second down.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
Throwing again is Tannehill. Gets this to Ferkser, the tight end.
he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Jaguars 33. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get three before halftime. From the left hash, it's an even 50-yard attempt. That's on target, but it's no good. He had it online, but it came up just shy of the crossbar. And this score will stay right where it is.
Well, he gets everything he could into this one. The trajectory's good. It's definitely online. It just needs a little more oomph behind it, and it'll wind up falling just shy of the crossbar.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And maybe a chance for a quick completion and then a long field goal try. We'll see. Final play of the half. It's Lawrence. He's going to loft it deep right sideline. And incomplete on the deep ball.
Certainly no lack of aggressiveness here. They were hoping for the home run play to get them 6 points. They're hoping for a catch, maybe a call. But they figure they can at least get into field goal range with a completion.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. The final shot before break. Lawrence, he's going to go up top again. And that'll be off the mark, too far out in front, and it's incomplete. So we've reached halftime here in Nashville, the Music City, with the Titans out in front. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach!
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. Welcome, everybody, to our abbreviated version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. Okay, Brandon, thanks very much, and welcome, everyone, to this abridged version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. This game's had a little bit of everything thus far, and certainly plenty to look forward to as the teams are right back out there for the second half. So we'll get right back out there as well, as we'll turn it back over to Brandon Godden.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. Underway. This taken in at the goal line. And he takes this near the 25. Just a little pass there. Call it the 26. The Titans getting set to go here to begin the third quarter. And they've got the lead, CD. What do you expect from them in this second half?
Well, I like what they were able to do on the ground in the first half because they had a lot of success running the ball, and I certainly think we'll see more of that. But I'd keep an eye on that defense, and I think their coaches up in the box will do the exact same thing. If they start to see one or two guys start to creep towards the line of scrimmage, that'll be licensed to take some shots downfield.
Tannehill and the Titans come up now first and 10 at their own 26. The third quarter starts with a run by Peterson. And he'll get about three here as he's out to the 30.
Not a lot of running room there, not a place to make a cut and kind of exit out because they had everything bottled up. Looked to me like the linemen were taking on their blocks really well and giving up no creases.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. Back to throw, Tannehill. Completing it to the right side, Johnson. And he's out of bounds, able to take this one up to the 35.
Well, it appears that they read man defense and went to the out route, and what you have to do on that one is the receiver's got to make sure he works the defender towards the middle of the field to give himself space to cut to the outside and have that ball delivered with good timing, and they got it done.
54.
They'll run it. Here's Peterson. And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37.
I like this focus there because he wasn't thinking about breaking that one big. All he thought about was, I need one. Let's go get that. Ended up picking up two.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Here's Tannehill. Looking left sideline, but it's incomplete.
Right now, the story of this game continuing to be the defenses, because the offenses, they're finding it difficult to establish any rhythm whatsoever.
I like how you come to us in praise of defense, Brandon, because that's exactly right. That was an incompletion for us there, but we've seen it throughout this game. Both of these defense coordinators, they're a step ahead of their offensive counterparts.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. They run Peterson. And this winds up a pickup of two, maybe two and a half, to about the 39.
Sometimes you're aligned perfectly and the play comes to you, and sometimes you got to cover some ground to go make the plays we just saw there.
We saw a great example of perseverance right there on that play.
Got to be careful. They might want to throw one over his head as this game progresses.
Throwing on third down, Tannehill. He finds his man complete. It's Peterson. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that.
We can make this one pretty simple. Locked up all of his progressions downfield, forced to get it to his running back. But how about the way they ran to the football and knocked him down to force a fourth down?
Here's Brett Kern now. And the way this offense has moved the ball, he hasn't been needed till here in the third. This is away, but boy, headed straight for the sidelines. And no return here. Where will they spot it? They say just outside the 20-yard line. Here comes the Jags offense now. Time for their first possession of half number two.
And their defense did its job by forcing the punt to start things out. And now, Charles, can the offense get in gear?
I think, partner, you can sense them saying, okay, the first half was theirs, but now let's get the momentum back on our side. We forced a punt. Now let's go downfield and score. If we do that, we'll be set up well for this second half.
They start the drive with Hyde. And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple, and that's it.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense, rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front, because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
From the 24, Lawrence. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
We've seen these defenses make enough opportunistic plays to keep this one low scoring. Flying around, making plays on the ball, and we see yet another errant throw as a result.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Out of the gun, it's Lawrence. Throwing left side, it's complete. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield.
That's a play that'll likely be forgotten when you talk about big moments in this game. But plays like this are critical to keep drives going. And if points result, we'll call this play significant.
On first and 10, it's Lawrence. And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down.
As his old brain remembers, when I see five wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out hot. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
Second 10 coming up here in Nashville. Third quarter action.
From the gun, a give to Hyde. Looking for a cutback lane, but nothing there as he's met at the line of scrimmage. Officially nothing on that one, no gain, so they're left with still 10 to go on third down. On third down, Lawrence. Buying time to his left. And Lawrence going to smartly hit the deck here as he is able to pick up the first down in the process.
We just saw a nice example of why teams often bring in baseball guys to teach quarterbacks how to slide in key situations. You want to protect your franchise guy. Make sure he doesn't get hurt. He did exactly that on that play. A perfect slide to avoid the big hit and pick up a first down.
Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move, first and 10. They go play action with Lawrence. Finds the open target, Arnold. And inside the 20 before he's brought down.
It's taken a while for this offense to get going. A little creaky at the start, but they're oiled up now. A nice throw there, and they're really putting together a good drive.
Under a minute to go in this third quarter as they come up first and 10. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. He finds his running back, Hyde. This will be a 5-yard pickup as they move it from the 20 to the 15.
I know it was a gain, but you have to sense probably a little bit of disappointment there, because when it's out there in open space, I think they expect to get more out of a play, don't you?
Especially when you're getting it to your guy out of the backfield. You're expecting him to be able to create something, be a little more shifty.
Yeah, no doubt about it. Good open field tackling held it to an okay game.
Third quarter of action. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. And he takes it in. Touchdown, Jacksonville. Carlos Hyde, a 3-yard touchdown run. And the Jaguars have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. Going for two, they'll kick the point after. And they're back within a field goal. It's 10-7 now. A 10-play drive that time. And it was capped off by a Carlos Hyde touchdown run.
After the touchdown, Cook now to kick this one away. Returning it, Johnson. And makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. The Titans getting set and ready to go here for their next drive.
They've been asleep for a little while on this side of the football, Charles, and the score is just a one-score game now. Haven't had any points this half. What gives?
Let's go old school here. All right, let's get back to the basics. Get back to running the football, high-percentage throws. Find the guys that eat pressure and make plays for you and make sure they touch it.
Tannehill and the Titans come up now first and 10 at their own 23. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. This will be caught by Brown. And they're able to get this one across the 35.
Well, how about this aggressive approach? Got the lead, fourth quarter, continuing to throw the football. Are you thinking about Super Bowl 51? Atlanta had the lead against New England, and they ended up giving it up.
I was going to say, don't say it, but you did say it.
I did, didn't I?
Yeah, anybody watching Atlanta, our apologies.
On first and 10, Tannehill. That's taken in by Ferkser. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35.
And these guys certainly are not hiding what their intention is. They're absolutely showing it. They're definitely not going to sit on this lead here in the fourth quarter.
So in Jacksonville territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 34. A 10th carry now for Peterson. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up.
In order to play really good run defense when you're playing a 3-4, those three guys up front, the nose tackle and the guys they call the defensive ends, they're usually big, big people because they're going to have to eat up a lot of blockers because it's usually 5-on-3. And when they do their job well, guys who play on the inside, those inside linebackers, they're able to just roam and hit.
Meanwhile, Tannehill's throw complete here to his receiver, Brown. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Jaguars 21. This is something you got to be wary of defensively. I mean, just because they're in the mode of trying to burn some clock doesn't mean they won't pass it. They got good yardage out of that one.
Yeah, and really, when you're looking at it, now they've got a fresh set of downs. Look for second down. If they want to take another shot and try and loosen things up, that'd be the time to do it.
Oh, no, he lost the football. And did the Jaguars come up with it? They did.
Well, that takeaway, partner, right there, that's a combination of coaching, execution, and absolute belief. Because a lot of guys will look at the scoreboard and go, ah, this thing's pretty well done. But they still thought to themselves, if we can make a play, we give our teammates a chance to win it. And that's exactly what they did.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Following the fumble recovery, Lawrence. And the timing a bit off that time as that one falls to the ground.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes. But the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. From the gun, it's Lawrence. And a dump off here to Robinson. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. They get 6. That'll leave him with 3rd and 4. Looking to throw, Lawrence. And that is incomplete.
How about some applause for the defense there? They forced him to throw that one into coverage, and just like that, they're staring at a fourth down. Well done.
Here's Logan Cook now as he's on to punt for Jacksonville. A 39-yard punt, a return of five, and the offense will take over with a new set of downs.
Here's Tennessee ready to begin this drive offensively.
A little less than 4 minutes remaining, and the margin for error is small with this slim lead. Operate within your four-minute offense here, Charles?
Definitely. Remember, the four-minute offense doesn't always correspond to what's up on the clock. What they need to do is play a little bit of keep away right now. Run the clock down. Make sure their opponent doesn't get the ball back. Their dream scenario, get enough first downs and make them eat up their timeouts so the game ends when you're kneeling down with the football.
And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Miles Jack there to make the tackle. And when do they start thinking about burning these timeouts? They've got all three still defensively.
To me, you have to start right now. Here's the time, and that means you've got to stop them on defense, not give up the yardage, use your timeouts in order to get the ball back and try and score yourself. But now is the time to start using those timeouts.
And keep in mind, it'll also stop the clock at the two-minute warning. This is caught. It's Brown. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. Three points separating these two sides with 2 minutes left to go in the fourth. So the Titans in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They've got a first and 10 as they look to try and finish this one off. They'll try and wind down some clock with Peterson. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40.
Yards rushing on 12 carries for him now. And carries like that, that's how they're going to continue to salt this thing away here, Charles, in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, how about that? A new set of downs. Clock continues to move. No better way to close out a game than to tap those mastodons you have up front and say, guys, keep pounding them. Let's keep the ball, keep their offense on the sidelines, and let's close this one out.
Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Peterson. And I think this defense knew what was coming as he is smothered behind the line. And now with 1:52 to go, we get another pause in the action. A timeout here defensively. Now they contend with a second and 12 after the loss. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. Now the Jags will use the second of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. So a third and 10, and defensively a dime look, six DBs. Tannehill now to throw. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
They went with the dive look that time on defense, just flooded the field with defensive backs, blanketed everyone, took away all the passing angles, thus the incompletion.
Here's Brett Kern now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. And that ball's going to angle out at the 3-yard line. A beauty.
You need to get the ball away here in the fourth quarter while you just hold a slim lead. But that punt, absolutely ideal. They pin them inside the 5-yard line. They give their defense a really nice opportunity.
So here now, Lawrence and the Jaguars. Down 10-7. A minute 40 remaining. How will this thing pan out? We'll watch as they come up on first down. Throw. He finds his man complete. It's Arnold. Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. Well, he gets attended to. We'll step aside. Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. They'll look to throw. Out to the flat for Hyde. And he'll get it up a little shy of the 15. They'll spot him down at the 14-yard line. A good rally to the football keeps him to only a yard, and it's second down. Now the Jags are moving quickly in the hurry up. He's back to throw. He finds his man complete. That's Arnold. Let's go. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
It drives some people crazy to see those short throws underneath. They've got to find a way to gash the defense downfield.
They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also third down. Back to throw. Throwing right, and that's complete. And he is going to have a Jags first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Huge first down, got to hurry.
Yeah, now they have to get up there, get set, and then spike it.
First down now, but the clock continues to move. Back to throw. And he will find his man on the outside. And he'll go out of bounds, it appears, right at the 45. It's a gain of 10, and the Jaguars first down.
Down, and Tucson.
Throwing now, Lawrence on first down. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. Huge play at this point in the game. Work to be done here on second and 16 after the sack. Lawrence. And too much juice. It'll be out of bounds, incomplete. Back-to-back big plays defensively. First the sack. Now they force the incompletion on third and long. Things looking pretty good for them.
And this is where they have to be careful because they've got the momentum going their way. They will be really amped up to get to the quarterback. Look out. Draw, screen, something that can be used against them.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And this nearly intercepted. Probably should have been. Had he caught it, it would have sealed it. Instead, one more chance coming up on fourth down. So after all of this, it comes down to one final play.
And just think of what it's going to be, because from this distance, you've got to be prepared for everything. Hooking laterals, tip balls, you name it. A lot of laterals after a catch. Just got to be prepared, stay on your feet defensively, and tackle someone.
One score down, here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. A final shot now for Lawrence. He's going to let it fly. And it's incomplete. So